Please welcome to the stage, Kat Davis! Humans, I have not always been the lesbian heartthrob you see in front of you. I was, I just didn't know it. I used to just be a little closeted kid in small town Indiana. Yeah. And man, she tried really hard to be perfect. You know, I always had a boyfriend. I was a cheerleader. I had so many boyfriends in kindergarten that we had to have a class meeting about it. Yeah, the teacher sat us down in a big circle. Because apparently every little boy in the class was my boyfriend at the same time, and she needed us to be in the sharing circle and learn that that is not how the world works. To which I said, "Excuse me, Mrs. King, if I may." And I went to every little boy, "Do you want to be my boyfriend? Do you want to be my boyfriend? Do you want to be my boyfriend? Do you want to be my boyfriend?" They're all going, "Mm-hmm. Sounds good." I said, "Well, I don't see the problem." Yeah, my mom got called. All that to say, I was very good at performing heterosexuality. Especially back then, when having a boyfriend just meant playing house and telling your husband to stay home and look after the kids while you put on a tie and head to work. Mrs. King's class had the best collection of dress-up ties. Got a little more complicated as we headed in toward middle school. People started doing things like, you know, the making outs and other stuff that seemed gross. I mean, I like making out, but, you know, so many school dances just slow dancing to songs about boners. Yeah. Anybody else go to middle school in the 90s? So many songs about boners. Anybody born in the 90s? Go fuck yourselves. The grown-ups are talking. No, I'm just kidding. Thank you for being here. Somebody card them. Yeah. That got older. Things got gayer. I would say it really came to a head the summer after my eighth grade year. Oh, I was best friends with Heather Marcus. Yeah. She's so hot. Aislinn's mom, you are so right. She's so hot. The thing is, like, she was, though. Like, Heather Marcus was the kind of girl, she had highlights and designer jeans and a waist that she was willing to let people see. I was just, like, all oversized dolphin t-shirts and, like, off-brand Birkenstocks my mom got at Shoe Carnival. But Heather Marcus, oh, she had this like lion lady face, like puffy lips like you'd pay for in Beverly Hills. And straight teeth, she had her braces off, they polished those things and filed, oh man, she was amazing. Aislinn's mom knows. She was amazing. And she was my best friend. It made no sense, just for that summer. She had a falling out with her real best friend and I was there to pick up the slack. She was cool, I was not cool. And we had an interesting summer. There was a lot of sitting in her windowsill, smoking Virginia Slims that we stole from the carton her mom had in the freezer. We'd sneak those cigarettes, sit in the window next to her palatial waterbed, beckoning in the moonlight to only me. And it was a hard summer, truth be told. Heather Marcus was going through some shit, and there was a lot going on, hard time at home. And there were so many nights when I'd be laying in bed, and she'd think I was asleep, and I could tell that she had started crying. And I wished there was something I could do to make it better, and I didn't know how, and I didn't know what. I just remember laying there, looking at her back, and wishing I could hold her. And being so afraid of what holding her might mean. read you Cinderella, you hoped it would come true, that one day your Prince Charming would come rescue you. You love romantic movies, you never will forget the way you felt when Romeo kissed Juliet. You dream of love that's everlasting. Well, baby, open up your eyes. I could love you like that. I could make you my world. Move heaven and earth. If you were my girl, I would give you my heart. Be all that you need. Tell you you're everything that's precious to me. If you give me a chance, I could love you like that. You want tenderness, I've got tenderness. And I see through to the heart of you. If you want a love you can be proud of, you don't have to look very far. I could love you, I could love you like that. I could make you my world. Move heaven and earth. If you were my girl, I would give you my heart. Be all that you need. Tell you you're everything that's precious to me. If you'd give me a chance, I could love you like that. I could love you like that if you'd let me. Except it wasn't even that yet. You know, I didn't have the words. I couldn't articulate it. I wasn't sure what was going on in my body, and it was a pre-gay Midwestern era. You know what I mean? I didn't know any gay people. I barely knew the word except as an insult. I couldn't name this thing. I didn't know what to make of it, you know? Fucking Indiana, man. And so I didn't know. I couldn't talk about it. And I just had this sinking feeling that there was something horribly wrong with me. And that everybody was going to know. And then the perfectionism came creeping in. And it took a little turn into OCD. There was a lot of combing of arm hairs. Just a lot of it. I had a special little brush. So I was pretty sure, yeah, the arm hairs were what were going to give it away to everybody that I'm a monster, this unkempt fuzz. And so I ended up going to a therapist. Thank you, Mom and Dad. And eventually I worked up the courage to say to her out loud the thing that had really been tying me up in knots. And I said one day, you know, sometimes I think about kissing my girlfriends and I don't know what that means. And she looked at me and she said, well, I'm not gay. I can't help you with that. Gay. And I said, gay? No, me neither. No, of course not. No, I'm not gay. I'm not gay. Do you have any support groups where gay people talk? I could hear what they sound like, because maybe no, not for me. Cool, 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 cool. I'll be over here in this closet. Boink. And that's how that went. Indiana. But guys, things got so much better when I went to college. They remember college. They're still in it. Isn't it great? Isn't it great? It did, though. It got so much better. I went to a very liberal college on the East Coast, and I was a theater major. Oh, it's a whole new world. Oh, my goodness. And I didn't quite have it all figured out, but I remember coming home fall break of my freshman year and talking to my mom. And granted, I had not been telling her about, like, Heather Marcus and her alluring waterbed. But I remember sitting at the kitchen table and being like, Mom, it's really crazy. Everybody at school is either gay or bi. It's wild. And she's like, well, just remember, you're from Indiana. I'm not sure what that meant. So I went back to school, and you know, it turns out I am from Indiana, and I am also very, very gay. And really good at it. Yeah. I think I found my calling. Just really terrific. Doubled in women's studies after that. I'm super duper gay. And all of a sudden, all those like 90s love songs came rushing back with a whole new meaning. I'm not gonna lie, guys, it was a really good time to be me. And if you'd been there, ladies, it could have been a really good time to be you. Close your eyes, make a wish, and blow out the candlelight. 'Cause tonight is just your night. We're gonna celebrate. All through the night, pour the wine, light the fire. Girl, your wish is my command. I submit to your demands. I will do anything. Girl, you need only ask. I'll make love to you like you want me to. And I'll hold you tight, baby, all through the night. I'll make love to you when you ask me to. And I will not let go till you tell me to. Oh, girl. Slow, I ain't got nowhere to go. Aislinn's mom's gonna concentrate on you. You ready? Yes! It's gonna be a long night. Throw your clothes on the floor. Oh, I'm gonna take my clothes off too. I made plans to be with you, girl. Whatever you ask me, you know I can do. Oh, I'll make love to you when you want me to. And I'll hold you tight, baby, all through the night. You're a man, but you, when you want me to. And I'm not gonna let go till you tell me to, baby. That needs to happen in this theater. Bring it up. Oh, how, Meg? We're getting closer, but no, it's just not quite right. We'll know it when we get there. How, Meg? Oh, we are so close now, Martha. Oh, I can feel that we're so close, but just get a few more of the black keys involved. Oh, how, yes. Oh, make love to you and to also you. You tight, baby, all through the night. I'll make love to you when you want me to. And I'm not gonna let go till you tell me to. When I make a sweet and passionate, gentle, smart and full of role play, if that's what you're into. Cozy and cuddly or quick and fancy. Love to you. guys, gay sex, it's so good. Oh, we just had a bunch. Woo! That was quite an awakening for me, college. I think I gave some of you your awakening just now. Thank you. I've really been looking forward to that. Kathryn, can I get a sip of water? Woo! That's right. I'll make love to you. Okay, no, that part's over. So my humans. Yeah, after carousing and arousing on both coasts, this wild Mustang met her Sally. Yeah, that's right. I'm a married lady. I have a wife. Which means I am gay and I have rights. Yeah! They can try to take him away, but there will be paperwork. So, okay, there's a win. My wife is here tonight. She's gorgeous. That blonde pompadour. It's a good thing you're a little backlit, or I would not be able to concentrate. You're radiating so much heat. When I met my wife, I gotta be honest, I was not prepared for what was coming at all. She kinda came blazing in and grabbed me by the face and said, "You and me, I've seen the future and we're it." And I did not believe her at first. Went on a couple of amazing dates, actually, incredible dates. But the thing is, guys, I had just gotten out of something and I was like, "Oh, it's too soon, I can't do it." And I told her all of this and I broke up with her. Well, I thought I broke up with her, but after I finished talking about all my feelings, she just looked at me and said, "I think I'm in love with you too." I know. So that breakup didn't go so well. Or did it? Because now we've been married for almost 5 years. 5 years in May. We've been together for 10 years. And it's kind of crazy thinking back about this little closeted kid from Indiana that she never could have imagined this life, this wife, this incredible wife, this night, all the, how fun my life is and how gay. Like, she couldn't picture any of this. And I do remember being that little kid and trying to think about what my life was going to be like when I grew up. You know, and whenever I did, I was always, there were a lot of blanks on the page. I was always alone. You know, I thought about having a wedding, but it was really just me in a dress. And there was nobody down there waiting at the altar. And I imagined myself being a powerful single mom with like 9 adopted children, alone at the Oscars, sitting next to my best friend, Anna Klumsky, who also didn't have a date. So maybe I knew more than I thought. But the point is, that kid, I just didn't have a template for it. I didn't know that a life like what I get to live it was even possible. You know, because you spend so much time thinking about other people's ideas of what's natural and what you're supposed to be and what constitutes a family and what you're allowed to have and what you're allowed to feel and what your body should be and what it should want, and fuck that. And fuck that. Just putting together this set, I realized I spent so many years thinking that my body had betrayed me, and my heart, and my mind, and my soul, and I was damned, and I was going to hell, and I was wrong, and I was bad. And when I think about the progression from that fear to now, I have a wife. We had a wedding with 2 beautiful dresses and puppets. Because why not? There wasn't anybody waiting down at the altar because we both walked down the aisle after we flipped a coin to see who would go first. And now we live in a little house. We have a little yard and 2 stubborn shih tzus and more wigs than is reasonable because we met doing comedy. And I wake up every morning in a pile of dogs and blankets, and I make coffee in our coffee maker with my wife. It's amazing. And I just, you know, I used to think it was silly when people would refer to just them and their partner as their family. You know, but she says it, and she makes it real. And the most natural thing in the world. Looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel uninspired. And when I knew I had to face another day, oh Lord, it made me feel so tired. Until the day I met you, life was so unkind. Now you're the key to my peace of mind. You make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. When my soul was in the lost and found, you came along to claim it. I didn't know just what was wrong with me. Your kiss helped me name it. Now I'm no longer doubtful of what I'm living for. 'Cause if I make you happy, I don't need to do more. And you make me feel, you make me feel, you make me feel like a natural woman. Oh, baby, what you done to me? You make me feel so woman. I love you, baby.